here we are again. Who would have thought it would really have happened? It's happened. As you can see, there's a bit of a change of scenery. This is the bedroom. Apartment tour part two. You're welcome. So at college, I'm studying mathematics, but I'm not actually taking any mathematical classes this semester, which is a sad thing, believe it or not. But I'm taking some really good classes, one of which is Introduction to Film, which is really fun. Although I've learnt that I really didn't like writing essays. That's why I take maths. But it's been really cool learning about the different aspects of film. One of the great things about taking film class at the church school is that most of the clips that they show are pretty appropriate. Whereas I feel like they might not always be at other schools. I might be wrong. But anyway, it turned out I was wrong. But not in the way you're thinking. It's kind of a funny story, so I'm gonna tell you. So I think it was about my third week into school, and in one of my classes, we sit in a big theater with a big screen, and there's like 200 people there or something, and we have comfy chairs, fairly comfy chairs anyway. So comfy that if you sit back just enough, you can rest your head on the chair, which is always great. I love that. Sometimes it's a bit dangerous if you wanna stay awake during the whole lecture. But anyway, this week, we had been learning about documentaries, and our professor was showing us examples of different kinds of documentaries and stuff, and different aspects of documentaries. And he's about to show a clip and he goes,
"Now you're going to want this clip to stop, but just stick through it. Don't give up."
And then I start watching, and I'm watching very good because I am an obedient student. And this video is of, I think it must be somewhere in Africa, and there's some people in some old warehouse. There was a baby, and the baby was yelling, and it was obviously a sick baby. And so this other man comes to the woman holding the baby, I think, and he has the tiny prongs, and he had just put them... The thing is, I don't really know what the clip was about. I feel like there were people trying to replicate what doctors do for this child. And so they had this little prongy thing, and it had black stuff on it, black liquidy stuff, and so they got the baby, and then they took the baby by the wrist and they like pronged the baby, and then there would be this black thing that grew on the wrist, and they did it not just once, but three times on each wrist, and then they moved down to the feet. And throughout this, the baby was absolutely yelling at the top of its lungs, "This poor child!" And I was just watching and I was like... So I've always known that I'd been squeamish, but I didn't know exactly how squeamish I am until this day. I realised as I was watching that I was getting this hurting feeling inside of here, and my head was spinning a little bit. And so I realised, even though my professor had told me to keep watching, that I didn't have to do that. It's okay not to watch if I'm feeling this way. And so I decided to sit back as I do, and I realised that my ears were actually ringing, and also my eyes were starting to go really blurry. And so I just closed my eyes and I realised that I was going to faint. I'm actually quite prone to fainting. If you watched my videos from a long time ago, then you would know. And so here I was. I don't know if I actually fainted or not, but I know that I remember lying there and just hearing the child yelling and screaming and just still feeling that pain and that faintiness in me. And then eventually the crying stopped. And the really fun part is that no one knew that I fainted. The person who decided me, it was dark, they didn't see me. I was just lying back on my chair like any normal person would do. But after the lights came back on, I was still feeling really sick, so I managed to go and get my water bottle, be sipping on that while I absolutely didn't concentrate on whatever was going on in the lecture. I had no idea what was going on. And I had no idea where he showed that clip. There was about half an hour left of the lecture, so by the time I got out, I felt okay. And I happened to be sending a letter that day to my friend Ashley Bruff, who's a missionary up in Idaho. I was going to send her some chocolate, because I'm a good person and she likes English chocolate, and I had some. And so I realised, because we all know that when we faint we should have chocolate. If you've watched Harry Potter 3, we'll know this. And so I decided to take a bite of this chocolate and have her sacrifice a piece for me. And I went straight home after that, and we had donuts at home, so that was really good too. I ate all the donuts. Cause it's very important to have your sugars back in your body, hey? My favourite part of the story is the week afterwards in class, the professor goes up in the beginning, he goes, "So if any of you ever feel uncomfortable during any of the clips I show, I want you to come and tell me, because I'm very sensitive to these things, and I want to make sure you feel comfortable at all times." And I was like, is he talking to me? And so during the break I went up and told him, and I told him that I had probably fainted during that clip. And he was very appreciative of that information. And it was interesting because I actually asked him why he showed that clip, and this is what he told me.
"Well, sometimes documentaries, they just see something through to the end. Even if you want them to stop, they won't look away when you want to look away. They'll just keep at it."
It all makes sense now. But there's two things that I've learned from this experience. I'm incredibly squeamish. Always carry chocolate. Except I don't even have any chocolate at the moment. I hope you enjoyed this video. Give it a hand and tell me in the comments how squeamish you are. And help me feel less of a wimp. And I'll see you next week. Probo.